What's up, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Aha, and we're going back to their 2009 album Foot of the Mountain. Many of you will know the opening tune blew my mind, sonically in particular, though I have tried to catch up on the lyrics. A number of you talked about it or posted the lyrics, so once again, appreciation to all the Aha people. But yeah, it really made a big impact on me. Like, I'm fascinated by how this album is going to embody the sort of return of the synth and sort of articulate a more electronic sound. I have heard a number of people comment when I did that first reaction to the Bandstand that the way this album plays out perhaps explains why they decided to call it quits after that. So I'm sort of thinking about a bit of the larger context, and also, again, the flow of their music over time and the different directions and sort of returns and like renaissances and so on. But yeah, bottom line, it was an amazing tune. I'm really excited for the rest of the album. The next tune is called Riding the Crest, which, you know, the crest of a wave is the zenith, the sort of high point. But it also is the point before which you begin to descend, right? It is the highest point, but also the final point during which you are ascending or plateauing, and it then begins to crash. Or at least, you know, it may not be like an ocean wave, but it might be a wave in a different capacity, maybe an emotional wave. You know, maybe it's more metaphorical. But it does indicate a sort of precarious moment in which you are at the high point of something, but you are therefore, you know, by definition or by necessary conclusion, about to face a descent or a decline. So it's interesting, the phrasing, but it does make me think of the experience when you're really riding high and it feels like, you know, nothing can go wrong and you have the best vision that you might have of everything, whether, again, that's more literal or, you know, feeling so great because you're in a relationship or your life seems to be going well and everything is sort of in your front view screen. Yeah, I feel like there's some different ways that you could go with the title, but I do enjoy the simple poetry of it. It's another title that has like a nice kind of literary quality to it. So let's listen. This is Aha. The tune is Riding the Crest, and it's from their 2009 album Foot of the Mountain. Feels like an homage to the 80s.
Riding the crest of a high. poetic phrase. Sound, the synth bass, and in fact I think someone mentioned, maybe it was in regard to this tune, maybe a different one, but that there was sort of like a video game sounding layer that wasn't their favorite. You know, I do listen to some chiptune, and I get it, it's sort of niche, it's, you know, I think a product of the fact that I grew up as a kid in the 80s, you know, played video games in the 80s, heard a lot of electronic sounds, again, I started listening to synth pop. So yeah, for me, I enjoy a good chiptune layer. I think it can be overdone or done poorly, but I like the way that hit there. So yeah, that's all good by me. But again, all opinions are welcome, so if you're not fond of that, do let me know. And yeah, it was just a cool tune. Lyrically, I'm not sure exactly what's happening, but you know, riding on the crest of a beautiful wave, it does seem like there is sort of this dynamic of like, being in a good place, but I'm just not quite sure, you know, how it relates and what the other person like is to them specifically. So yeah, gotta listen to it some more, but I really enjoyed it sonically. I'm thinking that's gonna be the case. You know, a couple people whose comments I really agree with, they've mentioned that, you know, there really isn't too much of a weak track on this album. So yeah, I'm just really looking forward to the sound. And like I said, there was that one moment, it was always like before the next verse. So there was like a moment early on before the first verse, and then after the chorus, before the second verse, and so on, that felt like it was deliberately kind of an homage to their 80s synth pop sound. Whereas the other sections were electronic, but they felt like there were some aspects that gave it a more modern feel. I mentioned that like the synth bass, it had that kind of dynamic sort of kind of danceable, jumpy feel of a lot of 80s synth pop, but there was like a harder kind of drag layer down at the bottom electronically too. So like I said, it felt like there was both an homage and a modernization of that synth pop sound. So basically what I'm saying is another great track. Really looking forward to the rest of the album. Let me know what you think of this one. I will see you next time.
Peace.